guys. Day two, Darren here. We are in Gundagai, New South Wales, which is about 500 odd kilometres from home. We left Melbourne last night, got here just after midnight with a couple of stops along the way. We booked this place online. It's the Gundagai River Caravan and Camping Park. So luckily we were able to book a spot as we were flying down the freeway. So that was all cool. Had a good night's sleep. So it's morning time and we're about to leave. We're heading to Burril Lake, New South Wales. I've never been there, but we're heading there today. So we're going to go see Grant from Designer Echo Tiny Homes on the way to Sydney. We'll see you soon. From Murrumbina.
What are we doing?
We're stopping to have some bread and chilli.
Are we getting coffee?
Yeah, we better get coffee because I know what you like with our coffee.
I don't know why they have the flashy right where the entrance isn't.
I like it well.
Really? Really? That says open, the other sign says closed. Not open. Open or closed? Ask them.
guys. We are on the road, on the way to Burril Lake, New South Wales. Someone asked, or a couple of people have asked, or wondered, why we're doing all this stuff, why we do these interviews and presentations and all that sort of stuff. And the fact is, a couple of points. Firstly, not everyone's on Facebook. I know we've got a big presence on Facebook, but not everyone's on Facebook. And in the real world as well, everyone knows people that know people that know people. So it's our way of helping to further spread the word. Yes, there are some business aspects to Tiny Houses Australia, but us doing these presentations and when we're invited to be interviewed on radio or invited to get up on stage at the home shows, some of these events, are they paid? Some of them are, some of them aren't, the majority are not, but we do it because we believe in what we're doing. And even before I met Lisa 4 years ago, when I came across tiny houses, it made sense. It still does. And we want to let more people know about what tiny houses are and what benefits they can bring to help, further spread the word. And that's why we do what we do. I know you'll probably hate it, but I've got another question for the day. Another question that we ponder as we're driving. Where are you guys at with your tiny house project? Are you still dreaming about it, planning it? Are you working on your floor plan? Have you actually started building? Have you finished? Are you living in your tiny house? Let us know.
Show us your bragging pictures.
Yeah, show us your pictures. Share with us, your floor plans, even if they're sketched out on a napkin or a bit of paper. Show us your floor plans. Show us where you're at with your construction. Good, bad, or ugly, let us know where you're at. And let us know what state you're in as well.
Yeah, because when you show us, you'll be showing everyone else in the group, and I'm sure everyone else will get just as excited.
And you never know. You might think, oh, this is shit, this has taken ages, but I guarantee any photos you put out there will help inspire others to do it as well. So show us your stuff. Question while we're, or a topic while we're stuck in roadworks. I don't know what we're doing here. Tiny house sleeping. Got kind of two options, a loft versus a downstairs sleeping option. What's your thoughts, Lisa? What do you prefer?
I prefer a loft.
Why is that?
I like the idea of having a separate private sleeping area.
Yep.
I don't necessarily want to look at my bed, even if it is a Murphy bed or a pull-out bed. When you're in the bed, I don't want to feel like I'm in the middle of the living room.
Yeah. Mm. And as you said, it can be set up as a permanent bedroom space. Yeah. You don't have to fold things out, put things away. One of the downsides of a loft is that most people can't stand up.
I can.
Yeah, because you're wee.
Well, I'm designing. That's the thing. They're tiny houses. They don't have to be so tiny that you can't put a loft in or a separate sleeping area in. I mean, unless you prefer the option of having it down in the main area, because you don't want to climb stairs or ladders. That's fair enough too, but for me, I just like that. And I think they're cute as well.
I like the whole treehouse secret space, secret climb up to my treehouse kind of feel about them. And it does, let's face it, it does maximize the vertical space that you've got in the house. Okay, if you're 6'4" as it is, and you put in enough room to be comfortable downstairs, then you put a loft in, yeah, you may not have any sort of reasonable headroom at all. But if your average height, you know, 5'1" to 5'7" or thereabouts, should be plenty of space. What do you think of the downstairs sleeping options?
I think it's good for those who have trouble climbing stairs and ladders. I think they're good as an idea for a guest sleeping area.
Or perhaps for people that don't have kids, you know, they're just either a single person or a couple and they just want to maximise that open feel of the house.
Each to their own. Yeah. I have my personal preference and that's a lot.
That's it. So what do you guys think? Let us know in the comments below what your preference is. There's no right or wrong. You know, have you got a loft? Or are you planning a loft? Or is that the last thing you'd want? Let us know in the comments below what you're doing and why. And yeah, add to the conversation. I don't know what the river is, but we're here. There's a river. Nice, actually, we should remember this spot. Don't know what the river is. That's the freeway up there. That's where you go for a wee. Because you need to do that sort of stuff on road trips. Nice.